The next important point is to be considered over here is the last three options: trace precedence, trace dependence, and remove error. So I say the very first option is trace precedence. If I just click on that, you will see one arrow appearing on my screen, which is actually telling me from where 15 number has come. So it is telling me that the 15 number has actually come from these many numbers. So trace precedence will actually trace the input values that you have used in a particular cell. In a similar manner, if I place my cursor anywhere else and then I say trace precedence, you will see two arrows appearing over here, because indeed F17 is using two inputs. One is D21, which is the first arrow, and the next is the A21, which is the second arrow. Let me place my cursor on any other cell, and now let me press trace precedence. And now you will see further two arrows pointing at the two input values which are being used in the F19. In a similar manner, if I place my cursor at D21 and then I press trace precedence, it will actually give me the arrow highlighting all the numbers that are being used to arrive at that number. So I repeat, trace precedence will actually track down the input values that you have used in that particular cell. So it is very helpful. Reason being, you know, if I have a very big data, you know, very big table, and I'm doing very complex calculations over there, it is next to impossible to go to individual cell one by one and then see whether this is the same right input which I've used in my output or not. But by trace precedence, by the help of this arrow, it can actually take me to that individual cell which is being used in that particular output. Similarly, if I go to dependent option, it will tell me the, you know, let me go to B21. That will give me better answer. So if I go to trace dependence, you will see now it is becoming actually more complex, because there are three more arrows which are actually pointing out the cell which is using this particular B21. So wherever B21 is being used, it will actually show you arrows for those cells. So if I just check, if I check F16, we are using B21, that means F16 is dependent on B21 for that value. If I go further to, okay, D is not using. If I go to F18, it is also using B21. So I repeat, the difference between the trace precedent and trace dependent is that trace precedent will track down the input values, and trace dependence will track down all the dependent cells which are using the input values from the previous cell. And that way, when it is giving me the error, very easily I can make out the root and I can solve the error if it is there in the Excel sheet. Now you see that the table has become very untidy because there are so many arrows on my screen, right? So I can remove these arrows also just to make my table very neat and clean. So just in case, you know, when your boss is asking you to, let me know the input or let me know the dependence, you can very easily press this trace dependent or trace dependence. And after, when your work is over, you can remove the arrows to make your table more neat and clean. All right. Now, next point is, I have to tell you a very important thing about the shortcuts that we can use with the trace dependence. Right. So. We have a disadvantage of using shortcuts. So there are certain shortcuts that we can use for the tracing of dependents or precedents that we can use over here. So let me just write the heading dependent and precedents. Right, and you will see the shortcoming just now when I try to tell you the answer. Okay, that's the problem. So what's the problem? So it is A23O. I wrote something else over there, so let me just write A21 over there, so this will give me the right answer then. So I have this particular option over here of shortcuts. So I'll write over here, the first shortcut is you have the control plus starting square bracket. I'll write this bracket the bigger font so that you can actually see the difference between square bracket and the curly bracket. Wait a minute. Over here, now you can see that, right? So one shortcut is that if you want to trace any precedent, the option is that you press Control and starting square bracket, right? So if I place my cursor at any point in this table, and if I press Control and square bracket, it will move the cell from F17 to D21. I mean, now you see that when I'm using shortcut, it is not showing me any arrow, right? But arrow is more useful because, you can easily make out the movement of the cursor. But if the arrow is not there, you will actually figure out, where the cursor has gone, especially when you have more rows and more columns. So I repeat, when you want to trace down any precedent, the shortcut is Control plus starting your square bracket, right? If you want to trace any dependent, the shortcut is that Control plus ending square bracket. Let me just increase the font size so that we can see the ending square bracket. So if I place my cursor anywhere, and now if you see, it is tracking the errors which are now coming here because of these reasons. So if I just say Control end bracket, actually, there are no dependents over here. So let me go to B21 and I say Control end bracket. This will actually move the cursor from B21 to F16. And again, in this case, there is no arrow. So the only disadvantage of using shortcut is that it will tell you about the precedents and dependents, but it will not show you the arrow. So especially, arrows are basically used when you are a beginner and when you have you can't make out the movement. But certainly you will see the experts or the, more experienced people normally will not use this arrow, especially with the small table. So if the table is small, you can easily use the shortcuts and go to the dependent or go to any precedent. Then we have another option. If you want to trace your all precedents, then what you do, the option is you press Control plus Shift, right? And then the starting curly bracket. Let me just increase the font so that you can see the curly bracket. Let me make it bold also. So this will actually trace down all precedents. So if I just, put my cursor anywhere in the table and I say Control and this, it will actually, if I just see here, the precedent was D21. Since it was only one, it will tell you, let me just put it again. So again, it will not show you any arrow. It will just say that, let me just do that. And if you see, it has highlighted those two columns. So A column and D column. And first it will highlight the D16, and then from the A21, it won't move further. So if I just press further, let me see what happens. It will not go further. So no cells were found. So it will only highlight the two columns that are being used in this particular cell. Let me do that one more time. So if I have this, it will highlight that whole column which is being used in this particular cell. So shortcut is more useful when you know a lot about this input value that you're using in the cell. But I still suggest that the easier option is always to go to the formula option and just click on that. And when you want to track down all dependents, the shortcut is Control plus Shift and closing curly bracket. So I'll just increase the font size so that you can see what we are doing. Again, it will not show you any arrow, and it might result into any, confusion with respect to movement of cell from D to E or A to B or any other cell. So normally we don't use that. So, and now if you see, the errors have started coming in. So we have A24 because we have actually written more points. So that's okay, we can actually correct that, right? So this was all, and Control backtick, you already know, is the shortcut for your showing formulas. But avoid using them, because when we have a simpler option with us, why don't we use that? So we have formulas, and these options are just a click away. So you just press on trace precedence or trace dependence. It will actually show you all options there and then. Right?